Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the Li-Fi technology, which is the abbreviation of a term, light fidelity. So in simple terms, we can say that this Li-Fi technology is nothing but a light-based Wi-Fi technology. And as we know, this Wi-Fi is fully networked bi-directional wireless communication technology, where data is being transmitted using the radio waves. While in case of a Li-Fi technology, the data is transmitted in the form of visible light using the LED light source. So these household LED bulbs and LED lamps, which are used as a light source, can also be used to transmit the data. So first of all, let us understand how this Li-Fi technology works. So if you see any LED light source, if you provide a constant current to this LED bulb, it provides you the constant illumination or a constant brightness. So as we change the current that is flowing through this LED bulb, the illumination or a brightness of this bulb will change. So this principle is used for transmitting the data wirelessly using this Li-Fi technology. So if no current or minimum current is flowing through this LED bulb, then the brightness of this LED source will be minimum, and that will be treated as a digital zero. So the digital zero will be transmitted at the receiver side. Similarly, when the light bulb is on, or we can say that if maximum amount of current is flowing through this LED bulb, then the illumination or a brightness of the LED bulb will be maximum, and that will be treated as a digital 1. So whenever the LED is on, so digital 1 will be transmitted at the receiver side. So in this way, by flickering the LED light source very rapidly, we can transmit the data in the form of ones and zeros to the receiver. And if this flickering is happening at million times per second, then we cannot see this flickering by our naked eyes, and we can treat this LED bulb source as a normal regular bulb source. So now let us see the schematic of a Li-Fi transmitter and the receiver system. So as you can see, the data which is coming from the web server or internet, first it will go to the modem, which provides the necessary modulation to the incoming data stream. Then this modulated data is fed to the LED driver, which changes the driving current for this LED bulb according to the incoming streaming data. At the receiver end, if you see, the optically received data is first converted into the electrical signal using the photoreceiver or a photodiode. And after the signal conditioning, this data is being fed to the computer or a laptop. So to receive this incoming data, at the receiver side, we require the Li-Fi dongle, which consists of a photoreceiver as well as the IR transmitter. Now this infrared transmitter can be used to transmit the uplink data back to the LED source. Now one such company which provides the complete Li-Fi solution is a Pure Li-Fi, which generally makes these Li-Fi dongles. So now as we know how this Li-Fi technology works, now let us see the advantages of this Li-Fi technology over the other wireless communication technologies. So these are the some of the advantages of this Li-Fi technology over the other wireless communication technologies. So first, let us talk about the speed. So far, researchers have achieved the data speed up to the 10 Gbps in the lab scale prototype models. And this speed can further be enhanced by using the array of LED source or by using the multiple colors of LEDs like RGB LEDs, where each LED source is able to transmit a data up to the 10 Gbps. So using such technologies, the researchers have achieved a maximum speed up to the 100 Gbps. So now let us compare its speed with other wireless communication technologies. So if we compare it with the 4G LTE or particularly the LTE Advance, then the maximum achievable speed under this LTE Advance is a 1 Gbps for the stationary user and a 100 Mbps for the mobile user. But all these speed are the theoretically achievable maximum speed, but actual speed may be much lesser compared to this theoretical achievable maximum speed. So if you see the countries which provide the fastest internet in the world, the average 4G LTE speed in such countries is in the range of 40 to 50 Mbps, which is much lesser compared to the speed which is provided by the Li-Fi. So now let us compare the speed of Li-Fi with the Wi-Fi. Now in case of a Wi-Fi, if you see the standard IEEE 802.11.ac, the maximum speed which can be supported by this standard is 1.3 Gbps, and that is under the 5 GHz band, which is almost 100 times lesser compared to the speed which is supported by the Li-Fi. And if you see the another Wi-Fi standard which is not commercially available yet, that is IEEE 802.11.ad, the maximum speed which can be supported by this standard is 7 Gbps. And all the speeds which are mentioned over here are the theoretically achievable maximum speeds. but the actual speeds may be quite lesser compared to the theoretically achievable these maximum speeds. And still, if we consider the maximum speed which is supported by this Wi-Fi technology, the Li-Fi technology is still 10 times faster compared to this Wi-Fi technology. Well, right now, the speed which is provided by the Wi-Fi technology is sufficient for our day-to-day life. But as we are moving in the era of Internet of Things, where each device is able to communicate with each other, soon you will find that the speed which is provided by the Wi-Fi technology is insufficient, and you will require the insane speed like a 100 Gbps, which as of now looks like a dream. So next, if you see the electromagnetic spectrum, the bandwidth of the radio waves is up to 300 GHz. But if you see the bandwidth of this visible spectrum alone, the bandwidth of this visible spectrum is around 300 terahertz, which is almost 1000 times more compared to the bandwidth of a radio waves. So not only you can achieve the higher speed, but also you will not find any kind of electromagnetic radio interference. So now in the case of a Li-Fi, as we are using the visible light source cannot cross the walls, unlike the case of a Wi-Fi, where the radio waves are able to transmit across the walls. So in this way, this Li-Fi technology provides the one more layer of a security. So these are the advantages of this Li-Fi technology over the other wireless communication technologies. So now let us see the different applications of this Li-Fi technology. So this Li-Fi technology can be used in the hospitals. As this Li-Fi technology is providing very high speed internet communication, so the real time health monitoring of the patient will be possible. So apart from that, this Li-Fi technology can be used for the underwater communication. Also using this technology, the vehicles can communicate with each other using the front and the rear lights. And using this technology, we can prevent the accidents. Also, this Li-Fi technology can be used in the aeroplanes to provide the internet to the passengers. And not only that, if this technology is fitted into our street lights, then even our street light can provide us a high-speed internet. So these are the some of the applications in which this Li-Fi technology can be used. But still, if you see, this Li-Fi technology is the futuristic technology. That means commercially, there are no products which are available which provides an insane speed up to the 10 Gbps or a 100 Gbps. So in the upcoming years, we might see the technologies or the devices which support this Li-Fi technology. So right now, as we are seeing the free Wi-Fi zone in the cafeteria, in future, we might see a free Li-Fi zone in the cafeterias. So now the bigger question is, if Li-Fi is the future of internet, then what about the already existing wireless technologies? The answer is that in future also, all the existing technologies will remain, and rather this Li-Fi technology will complement all the existing technologies. Because this Li-Fi is the short range communication, so using this technology, we cannot cover the entire area using the light. So grossly, if you say, when you require a large coverage, we will still prefer the Wi-Fi and the 4G LTE. But in the short coverage, like in case of our room or hotel or even offices, we can still prefer this Li-Fi technology. So I hope in this video you understood about this Li-Fi technology. If you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.